Hey guys, welcome back to our weekly online art lesson. My name is Neil Young and I am an administrative assistant here at the Southern Alleghenies Museum of Art in Altoona. So last week I started off with showing you guys some of the William Rao collection and his beautiful photographs, but I thought this week we would show off some of the more artwork that we have displayed here. The other side of the museum is the Woodstock show. So this is one of the examples of a poster that we have displayed. This collection was from a gentleman named Mark Del Costillo, and this is a very important show to me. I feel that it really captured the hippie culture and the 1960s. So if you don't know, Woodstock was a concert that took place in 1969 in New York. It showcased a lot of rock stars that we might have already heard of, like Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin, CCR, The Who. But it was very important because of the timing. 1969, our world was sort of chaotic. We had war going on, the Vietnam War. A lot of protest was going on, and Woodstock was a way of just spreading love and peace in the world at the time. So, this here is CCR. That was the band that we were listening to before we got started. But with that being said, let's get to the lesson. All right, guys, so we are going to be doing a continuation of Keith Haring. If you might remember, our second lesson focused on Keith Haring. Here is another image of him. He's doing a really cool painting there. So I'm just gonna give a brief introduction in case anyone missed that second lesson of ours. And then we're gonna do a project that's a lot different than the first one. So, from a very early age, he fell in love with drawing. He started learning how to draw basic cartoons and was inspired by people like Dr. Seuss and Walt Disney. This led him to pursue art in Pittsburgh, PA, and then New York City. New York City played a very important role in Keith Haring's art career. Keith started seeing empty black pieces of paper on the subways, and he knew that was a perfect place for him to start drawing with chalk. I sort of talked about his chalk drawings before, but it was a way of him doing public art without damaging anything. So before he knew it, he started to become really famous. All the people who rode the subway saw his artwork, and it even started to appear on TV and in newspapers. One interesting fact about him is that he never signed any of these pictures that he drew. So people would just see this reoccurrence of characters, and that was his trademark image. People just knew him by his artwork. Keith also started showing art in galleries where people started to buy them. He once quoted, "I want to sell my paintings because it would enable me to quit my job, whether that's a cook or delivering houseplants or whatever else I am doing, and paint full time." This was a very important risk for him to take. Painting full time allowed him to create more and also form a very secret language within his artwork. Each character Keith drew represented something very important to him. He used his art to raise awareness for social causes. One of his most famous characters is the barking dog. So I think I showed this to you on our last Keith Haring lesson, but this is one that's very famous, the DJ barking dog. Here is another one. This was one of his most famous characters that he drew. And here is the basic form itself. So for today's art lesson, I was thinking that we could actually draw the barking dog. So let's get started, guys. So this image right here is very simple when we break it down into its shapes. It represents a dog, but is basically just boxed in lines, and we are going to get started with the head, actually. So like usual, I'm gonna start out with pencil to get my rough design on the paper, and then I'm gonna outline it in Sharpie so you can see it a lot better. So we're gonna start out here at the snout of the dog, the mouth, and we're gonna start with just a simple V that is facing this direction. So let's get started. Okay, so we're gonna have a mouth that looks something like this. Then we gotta focus on the ears. So as we can just see, there are two triangles to represent the ears. The first one is a tiny bit smaller than the second, just to give it a little bit of depth. So the first one, we'll get started. All right. So we have the two triangles without the bottoms and a line that connects the two. So we're starting to see something that looks like the head of a dog. So let's then start out with the bottom. So as you can see, we have the four legs here. So we're going to simply just start drawing rectangular shapes without closing in the tops of them. All right, guys, so there is the very first leg. And we're just gonna do that same exact thing three more times. So we have four legs now. So from there, we're going to draw a line upwards from the back leg, straight up, and then make it bend just a tiny bit to represent the tail. And once again, that sort of looks like the shape of the legs, just a rectangular shape, but just not closed in. Which then will give us something like this. And then we're gonna simply just connect this line right here to that second ear that we drew. It's just a straight line. So, we have something that looks like a Keith Haring dog now. So once we're happy with this beginning outline in pencil, you can then take a Sharpie, marker, crayon, whatever you possibly have, and let's outline it. Now, make sure to do a bold outline. As you can see, Keith Haring was known for his black outlines on everything. All right, guys, so we're gonna end up with something that looks very similar to this. So from here, we are going to color in the barking dog. Here we can see that he left it white and then the background red, but let's do our own take on this and make it our own. When recreating famous artwork, always switch it up, never make it 100% the same. So let's choose a color for the barking dog. I think I'm going to use some Crayola markers, and I chose this mint color right here. So Keith Haring always called this figure the barking dog, but you can name this something else. You can name this after your pet dog or a dog that you would like in the future. Have fun with it. All right, guys, so keep coloring in. All right, guys, so we colored in our barking dog. So at this point, it's a good time to go back in with the black marker or crayon that we have and do a bolder outline. So in case you went out of the edges, you can sort of cover that up. You can sort of see I went off the edges here. So I'm just gonna make that a little bolder. So has anyone ever seen a Keith Haring artwork in person? There are actually a lot displayed in Pennsylvania. He did a collaboration with Andy Warhol, which is another artist that we did a lesson on. And they made a massive elephant sculpture. And Keith Haring did his doodle designs all over it. And it's actually on display at the Andy Warhol Museum right now. Beautiful piece, and it's really, really big. All right, so now we have outlined our barking dog. I think it looks pretty similar to the original. So, once we have that, let's combine two of his pieces. So here we can see two of the dogs with a ground, and then there's a background, and then we see some of these motion lines. Now, within artwork, you might see this in comics or cartoons. These lines here represent motion. So for this, it represents the dogs talking or barking. Sometimes if we had a dancing character in our last project and there were motion lines around it, that was representing dance and movement. So let's go ahead and draw some lines representing barking. And you can make these any way you want. You can do three, I think I'm gonna do four lines. So we have something that looks like that. Now, this dog is currently floating in space on our paper, so let's give him somewhere to stand. Let's do something that represents a ground. So next, we're just going to draw a horizontal line from left to right. And make sure not to intersect the legs. So, skip the leg, connect, skip again. So then we have this. Next, we're gonna have to choose another color that we would like to draw in the ground. And I think I'm gonna use a orange for this. Now, since we did not draw a square to begin, your edges do not have to be perfect. You can just sort of scribble to the edge and leave the edges rough, and I think it's going to give a really cool effect. Once again, do not draw over top of the dog's legs, because we want to keep those the same color as the body. And if you do happen to go out of the lines, remember you can always save yourself by doing a bolder black line. All right, so we have a ground now. Now we can see that Keith Haring added some texture to the ground. So let's do that as well. Let's get that black marker or crayon that we have and just do some polka dots on the ground. These dots can be completely random, or you can space them out. Totally up to you. And if you are using markers, make sure not to put your hand in your marker when it's still wet. I have a bad habit of doing that. So I'm going to cover up that mistake of mine, just with a little bit more orange. So, who do you like more, Keith Haring or Andy Warhol? Now that we've done two lessons on each artist, I'm curious to see what you guys think. All right, so our finished piece is going to look something like this. Now, like I said before, Keith Haring never signs his artwork, but feel free to put your signature in the bottom, since now this is your own work of art, influenced by Keith Haring. So guys, thank you for tuning in. I'm very curious to see what you guys have created, and extra bonus points if anyone actually takes sidewalk chalk and goes outside and actually does a Keith Haring drawing on the sidewalk, because that would be pretty cool. So I will be doing another lesson on Thursday, and I will see you guys then. Like usual, post your pictures in the comments so we can see what you guys create. Thank you.